as you clicked in this video, I guess you want to know the great method of creating road markings in 3D. Well, you're in the right place, as this is the topic of this tutorial. But that's not everything. I have an awesome surprise for you. Check the details in the description below. Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I show you how to create nice, realistic road markings in 3ds Max. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, so you are sure you won't miss any future tutorials. So let's go to 3ds Max. So let's see what we have here. Let's start interactive rendering. Okay, so to be able to work fast on materials, I always try to leave only the necessary things in the scene. So we have a basic lighting setup done. We have some boxes in the scene to create shadows and reflections. You can notice that we also have this green object in the shape of the pedestrian crossing, however it does nothing for now. Let me hide the object for a moment so you can see the wet asphalt material. And the puddles are a separate thing from the road. By the way, this image comes from the rainy hotel shot from our advanced exterior training. Besides this image, we also show you how to create snowy scenario, forest image, and beach style visualization. I put the link in the corner and in the description below in case you want to check it out. Okay, so let's make sure that we have it as a non-renderable object. Go to the object properties and uncheck the renderable option. Here we go. Okay, as we have the scene prepared, let's create a mask for our road markings. We'll use corona distance texture. If you use V-Ray, choose V-Ray distance text. I plug it to the diffuse slot of my wet road material. Now we need to add an object to the node input, and it will be our green object. Let's reset the distance fire value. And let's turn on the color inside option. However, we need to make it white, while the other two will be black. Here is the effect. So we have crossing lines white and the rest of the asphalt black. You can also see that when I'm moving the elements of the object, it affects the material. We have full control here of how we want to change it. Okay, now let's create another mask to add some imperfections to the lines, as this is what makes images realistic, right? Copy the distance map and plug the new one to the diffuse slot or base color if you want to use corona physical material. This time, uncheck the color inside and make color far white, and let's adjust the distance far value. We want to create a soft gradient here, so 0.1 meter looks fine. Okay, so now we can combine both masks. Plug the first one to the diffuse slot and the second one to the inside color. We add a soft gradient to our mask around the lines, but it still can look better. Let's work on the second mask a bit more. We can use a smoke map and plug it to the distance scale slot. Now let's adjust the scale. Maybe a bit bigger. By the way, you can download this base scene from YouTube video. I put the link in the description below it. We can change exponent value as well to make it more contrasty. I think we should also increase the distance near value to make it more prominent. And let's increase the distance far value as well to create a bigger gradient. Awesome! Let's plug the main mask to the correct slot. Great! We have imperfections visible now. I would stretch this effect a bit though. Let's change the smoke map size. I think it will be great if we can differentiate the scale of these imperfect transitions. we can create a mix from two different smoke maps to achieve this effect. Let's change the scale in the new smoke map. I use the noise map as a mask here. Maybe let's use a fractal noise type. Plug mix map to the distance scale slot and plug both smoke maps to the mix map slot. Okay, so we have the mask prepared. Now is the time to make it work with the main asphalt material. Let's plug the asphalt diffuse map again. In this video, I'll be using the polygon textures. I put the links to all used textures during this video in the description. Anyway, now we'll use composite map. The diffuse map will be our layer 1, while our mask will be a mask for layer 2. And finally, to layer 2 we will plug the color correction map. This will be our pedestrian crossing. Let's make them more white. Maybe a bit less, as in reality they won't be as clear. The lines look too perfect now, so we need to add some imperfections to them, so they will actually look like being used. I will use a glossiness map, but I will make it brighter and with less contrast. And use the same mask for the layer 3 and add this map to the layer 3 slot. Let's change this one to overlay and let's adjust the map a bit. The effect is too strong. Let's decrease the opacity. Let's adjust this map as well. Okay, it looks better now. Let's make some final adjustments. At the end, we'll add an ambient occlusion map. Let's use another composite map and plug another one to the layer 1 slot. And let's use the ambient occlusion map as layer 2. Change the mode to multiply and plug the final composite map to the diffuse slot. Okay, so basically, as you do this material once, you can copy it and adjust to your other scenes. It works the same if you want to create other road markings like lines between the roads, for instance. It's really easily adjustable. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video and you will learn this method in your future projects. Let me know in the comments how you like it. At the end, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced exterior training, where you will learn how to create this wet asphalt material, but also more other advanced materials based on 4 different images. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye!